While appearing before Parliament's Joint Committee of Tourism and Health, the Minister of State for Tourism, Martin Mugarra, warned that many provisions in Alcoholic Drinks Control Bill 2023 will negatively affect the tourism industry, mentioning Section 14(3), which prohibits sale of alcohol in the night after 10 p.m. and midnight on weekly days and weekends, respectively.
We are choosing the word night economy deliberately from nightlife. The bill also seeks to introduce a host of licenses and fees in addition to the already existing licenses and taxes. Imposed taxes and fees, including trading licenses, signpost license, billboard license, occupation and health license, medical examination fees, advertising fees, renovation license.
Mugarra also protested a host of licenses and taxes proposed by the bill, saying they will stifle businesses in the tourism industry. He defended his stance, arguing that the tourism and hospitality industry in Uganda is a major contributor to GDP. Prior to the COVID-19 pandemic, tourism earned Uganda 5.6 trillion shillings, making the sector a major player in the country's economy and an important exchange earner.
Entirely agree that government should maintain and enforce licensing for all alcoholic products. It is our view that small-scale distillers and retailers be allowed to operate under current trading licenses given by local governments to avoid the cumbersome process of applying for other forms of licenses.
So pay, they call it local service tax. There is a charge on every client every day. It is called local service tax, local hotel tax, and it's a local government tax. How do you remit that tax to the local government? How do you know this facility is in this local government?
The minister emphasized that the bill in its current form is not addressing the key factors responsible for alcohol abuse in the country, but rather concentrating on non-issues which would end up causing Uganda more problems, like killing the tourism sector that is generating revenue.
Nothing else in this bill that speaks to enforcing or reducing Ugandans on consuming alcohol. There is nothing. It just says in the licensed areas. So someone can buy as much as alcohol as he wants, goes to his home and drink until he dies. So that's why we are saying, what is the purpose of the belief? We are not curing this.
See that the minister is interested in guarding the interests of the tourists, the local business communities, the economy of the country. And since tourism brings a lot of money for this country, I realize that the minister is against the bill. So I would want to ask him a direct question. Do you support this bill?
On the proposal in Clause 5 that stipulates that the business premises involved in the sale, manufacture and distribution of alcoholic drinks shall be 400 meters from a school, health unit, residential area, place of worship or a fuel station, the Ministry of Tourism argues that it's not practical and enforceable given that most urban centers are poorly planned.
7B, which speaks to petrol stations not amongst the areas that would be licensed to provide this service. It is one of the products we are developing is to have these services also provided in these various stopovers along most of these routes, tourism routes, like what is on Masaka Road and the rest.
They told us that these hotels actually make more money at night, even bars and dance halls make more money at night than during the day. They actually said that life begins at 10 p.m. So meaning that the beer is unhappiness, it is unlife. From what they said is a bad beer.
Where we have issues is the consumption bit.
Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.